Of years. And she was rejected by her society. Her community abandoned her. Even the church never wanted her. She bled for 12 years. She stunk for 12 years. The odor that comes out of her body is something that you can't behold. But she never allowed her problem to deprive her of God's touch. Even the disciples prevented her. They stopped her. But she was desperate. She was so determined. She had no opportunity of hearing from Jesus. Not for one day did she hear from Jesus. But she had rumors about Jesus. She had repeated rumors about him. How he healed the sick. How he raised the dead. How he cured the blind. He heard a lot about him. How he walked upon the sea. And she built up her faith. And she said, I don't need to behold him. I don't need to hear this man speak. I have had a lot. The Bible says, faith cometh by hearing. And hearing the word of God. Indirectly, the woman heard the word of God. But those that heard the word of God directly from Jesus, they never believed. But this woman was determined. She said, if only I could touch the hem of his garment. I don't need to touch his feet. I don't need to touch the hem of the garment. She was desperate. How about Zacchaeus? The Bible told us in Luke chapter
19
from verse 1 to 10 a story about a man called Zacchaeus who was a tax collector who had so much about Jesus. But because he was a tax collector back in the days, tax collectors are criminals. Nobody wanted to associate with them. But the man needed salvation. He never saw Jesus. He heard about Jesus. And he said to himself, if only I will see him. If I could see him, my life will be changed. And the Bible said that Zacchaeus was a small man, smallish in size. When he heard of Jesus coming, he said, today, I'm not going to collect taxes. I want to see Jesus. He was desperate. Desperate men. They do desperate things. When you are desperate for the Holy Spirit, no matter what the doctor told you, no matter the medical report, when you are desperate for healing, you don't come to see the pastor. You don't come to see the apostle. You don't come to see the guest speaker. You are here to encounter Jesus. That's why I love desperate people. They don't care. Their eyes are focused on wanting and wanting alone the Holy Spirit. The crowd prevented Zacchaeus. The Bible says he climbed the sycamore tree. He climbed the tallest tree. As Jesus was teaching, Jesus realized there was a desperate man among the multitude. A desperate man, a criminal, a rejected man, abandoned man, frustrated man. But because he was desperate, the Spirit of God located Zacchaeus. And Jesus shouted, Zacchaeus, Zacchaeus, come down. Everybody was stunned. Everybody was surprised. They said, how come Jesus mentioned this man Zacchaeus? And Zacchaeus did not hesitate. The Bible says Zacchaeus climbed down. And Jesus held his hand. And said, Zacchaeus, today I will go to your house.
nyumba yo.
As they were moving,
era nga otambula.
As Zacchaeus was taken,
era Zacchaeus nga atwali.
If Jesus knew my name,
Yesu singa ya manye linya.
Without anybody telling him,
nga tali no mama mugambi.
He should not be a criminal.
Aja tege na ndibuzi wa misa.
If Jesus knew my name,
singa Yesu awada manye linya.
Without anybody telling him,
nga tali no mama mugambi.
He should not be a thief.
Ayo chima ya tindi mubi.
If Jesus knew my name,
singa Yesu awada manye linya.
Without anyone telling him,
nga tali no mama mugambi.
He should not lie.
If
Jesus knew my name, with nobody telling him,
you
should not have destroyed so many lives. If Jesus knew my name, without anybody telling him,
he
should not need salvation. And Zacchaeus thought to himself, as he was battling with the accuser of the brethren, and he told himself, Master, everything I have stolen, I will return it to the poor. He did not say to the church. He did not say to Jesus. I will return it to the poor. He did not say one time. He did not say two times. He did not say three times. He said four times. I will return it to the poor. And when he said this, Jesus did not pray for him. Jesus said, Zacchaeus, today, salvation is in your house. And Jesus is telling you, you don't need to pray.